Hi everyone. So today I want to share my experience on how to better collaborate with people using documentation. And I hope you guys are able to see the presentation. I'm just going to believe that you guys are seeing this. Okay. So the first question which I actually want to ask you guys is how many of you know what Zoomga does? Can anyone share, please?
You can rent a car with Zoomga. It has a fleet of cars, and you can also like put your car up on rent.
Yeah. So, did anyone of you like had a recent booking with Zoomga? Anytime during?
Yeah, anytime. Yeah?
So, how was your experience? Can you like just?
You spy a lot.
Okay, that is one feedback. We should actually solve this one. Okay, so I would like you to take you guys through how booking experience of Zoomga is. Okay, so basically you choose a destination, select the dates, and select your car, and payment. You have booked your car. The next thing is this screen. So this screen has all the information related to your car details, how to get to the car, and the payment information and like support. So the problem which I recently joined Zoomga around like in May of this year, and this was the first problem which I received. So the problem was customers were going to the location and they were not able to find the cars. See, the thing is, it's clearly mentioned here, right? That you can just navigate to your pickup site, find a car and inspect and go. So it's all in an automated process, but still people were not able to do it. And this was actually the impact, making an impact on our revenue. How was that happening is, so people call our experience team and they'll talk like, well, do you know where the car is? Okay, sorry. So people will ask, I am not able to find my car. Is someone there who can help me? And people are not educated that Zoomga is an automated model. So before it, so this screen was designed for the pickup site model where there was a parking site and there was a fleet guy who will always be there to help you guys. Okay. So the problem, as I started to discuss with the PM about how to approach the problem, I realized that there were almost 3 to 4 versions of this screen, which was previously worked on. And there was 2 to 3 designers who had already worked on it, 2 to 3 PMs. And the catch was nobody's working for it. Like nobody's working here right now. Okay. So, and there was no documentation. So, again, we had to start everything from scratch. That was one pain point that I had to go through. What happened with this is we had to do the research of each and everything. I'll show you one screen where so these were the issues that we faced. I had no clarity about the project. In fact, nobody in our like whoever, even Pradosh was working with me, and we had no clarity. We had to dig all the data from the scratch, and we had to do all the rework again. The time which we took to do this project was around 4 to 5 months. Even the project is still going on. We have completed 70 to 80% of it and we have positive results. But yeah, and for company, the people, the users who are using Zoomga, they were facing bad user experience, right? And the revenue was getting impacted. So I'll tell you a simple case. This was a previous screen. This was the next screen, next version. And so they have added one call button. Now, I don't know why they have added this button. Maybe this was because people were calling more, people were not able to find the contact. So they have given more accessibility. But now the calls have increased. So was this a good decision? Was this a bad decision? That was unclear to us. So these are the problems which you face when you don't have documentation, right? This is something which Karthi has explained wonderfully. I don't have to go in depth with this, but I'll just tell you something which I have written it down. From my personal experience, documentation helps our thought morph into words. And those words blossom into ideas and solutions. Okay. So something which I started around 2 to 3 years back is I started documenting stuff because I used to freelance in my college days. And generally what used to happen is like initial discussion with client will have certain things and will have certain actionable items. But eventually what will happen is when I'm shipping my project, he's like, oh, I did not ask for this. What is the problem? Like again, we'll have to do the rework. So this is some which I want to showcase. The video is not working, I guess. Okay, 1 second. No, the video is not working. Okay, so basically, what I do is this is a Confluence sheet, and what we do is we document. I started this. I document general activities of everyday stuff, research documents, learning and results, rationales behind all the design decisions that we take, minutes of the meeting so that we can set accountability. I'll come to that. And how this helped us is better project planning. We became good at time management since everyone was, this was transparent system. Okay, so if I tell, if the product analyst tells to me that, okay, I'm gonna give you this data tomorrow, but if I'm not documenting that, I am not putting it online for everyone. So what happens is he'll not give it to me. But if it is visible, then he will have an accountability, and then through that we started managing the time. Okay. So this is document mapping basically in that same sheet. So anyone who is involved with the product, any stakeholder, let's say CEO or the senior product managers who are working with us, they can easily go through this and they can see that, okay, 1st July, he worked on certain things. We analyzed certain call buzzing data and this was the result. And this is how we documented all these things. Day-to-day log, as you can see, this is something which really helped everyone get transparency. And this project was actually, you know, took very less time as we planned initially. Also the accountability part, which I just explained. So document actually helps everyone around you, right? Right now, what we are doing is we are evolving this. So this is my style of documenting. So Vivek has a different style again, but he has taken some importance or whatever knowledge I shared, he has taken that knowledge and he has improved on it. I can even show you after this presentation how other team members in our design team has actually made their documentation. So better documentation, better tomorrow. This is my presentation, guys.